past weekend, so you can tell I was tailgating and at the game and had some fun. So, you know, we've talked about costs, right? And what ransomware and malware and those types of things can cost, and downtime and ransom and data loss, right? And data theft. We've talked about how long can your services be down, right? And how do we recover from these situations? These are the number of incidents and breaches from this is a 2021 Verizon data breach investigation report. So where they have been, how. So Joe was talking about social engineering, basic web app, you know, application attacks, email attacks, all those types of things that Joe just went through. These are the numbers behind those. And then this is just a little bit more. Does it have a thing on here? Yeah. So, you know, email attacks are the number one, right? And clicking on those links. He talked about USB down here, right? Like picking up a USB in a parking lot, if you will. You know, and these are the ways that these attackers get into our data centers. And so how does a company like NetApp, right, data storage vendor, how do we help, right? Certainly in recovery with snapshots, and we'll go through that, but we also have detection and prevention capabilities. So we have SaaS-based offerings, specifically Cloud Secure, which is a part of Cloud Insights, which is a SaaS-based offering of ours, so it doesn't require any software that you guys build. You can build this as a part of your, and let me back up here, right, as your multi-layered. This is what Joe Shields talked about, right? There is no one single way to prevent or recover from ransomware, right? It takes a multi-layered defense, right? Zero trust defense, right? And recovery architecture to protect yourselves. And so we are just, you know, we have a couple of pieces of that. And so as we look at detection, right? Joe talked about endpoints. NetApp isn't at, you know, doesn't play in that game, right? With the exception of some VDI stuff that we can do, right? At the server layer, we do have some capability. And then, of course, at the storage layer, right? And this is really where we play with some of the tools we have, both built into ONTAP, which is our operating system, right, that runs on our engineered systems. As well as running Cloud Insights and utilizing F-Policy, which is one of the technologies that we really utilize to help fight ransomware, right? And what is F-Policy? It's a technology within our operating system that allows us to block certain extensions, right? So if we know, and integrating with some of these other tools and some of the other vendors that you'll talk, you know, that will speak behind me today, that Joe spoke about in his intro, right? And he had all the different vendors up on that, you know, one of his final slides, right? We can integrate with those companies that are looking at, okay, this is the next wave of malware, the next wave of ransomware, right? And these are the extensions they are using to get into your data, and it might be sitting out on your file server, right? Joe Martin talked about, you know, hey, the longest he'd heard of was a year, right? It sat in their environment for a year, right? Trying to outweigh your recovery capabilities. If you can find these things before they go off, these time bombs, right, as they're ticking, you know, this helps you prevent those attacks from happening. And this is where F-Policy and Cloud Insights and some other technologies that NetApp has can help with, right? These are just a few of the vendors that we work with, right, that have full integration with F-Policy. Many of them, I believe you guys are partnered with, not all, but probably many. And as you work with IP pathways and you build a security and data infrastructure, right, to be resilient, you know, against attacks and for recovery, it will be them, right, utilizing companies like NetApp, companies like Veeam, companies like Varonis, to build this multi-layer, right, zero trust architecture for your data centers. And NetApp is a piece of that with the technologies that these guys are very familiar with and how to implement those technologies, right, to recover and prevent attacks. Just a little bit more here on Cloud Insights and Cloud Secure, and you know, some of the things that Joe Martin was talking about is looking for changes in your environment, right? So we will look at things like file extension changes, as I mentioned. We will look at snapshots and how your snapshots are being affected, right? Or are they? Are they increasing? Are they decreasing to more, you know, more than what a normal level, what we would see, right? And we use machine learning and AI-driven architectures on the back end to find these anomalies, right, within your systems. And when we find them, then we can go into remediation and, you know, shut things down to keep it from you know, blowing up in your entire environment, and then go through recovery process. And we can do that very quickly, right? I mean, you guys are familiar with our snapshot capabilities, I'm sure, or even if they're not our snapshot capabilities, other snapshot capabilities where you can go back to a point in time and you can do it in a matter of seconds, right? So then you can worry about getting your systems back online so you're not incurring that downtime that costs data or costs money. So these are, you know, remediation things that we talked about, right? Contain, prepare, and recover. I've been talking about the snapshot capabilities. We have, and one of my final slides, and I believe Amy's getting these slides out to you guys, but we have plenty of technical reports out there, right, that will help you understand. And, you know, sitting here all day is great, and having, you know, myself and Joe and whomever will follow me present. Learning is really more about reading and understanding and getting into the technical reports that are out there and understanding the architectures and how they integrate, right? We're here really more from a marketing standpoint to talk about how we can do this for you guys and how IP Pathways has the professionals and the expertise to come to your guys' organization and implement this across the board, right? Because again, not one vendor has the answer, right? It is a multi-layered zero trust architecture to get that done. So hardening your snapshots, Joe mentioned snapshots are immutable, right? But does that mean they can't be deleted? No, right? And so we've seen attacks on our systems where the hackers got in, right? They set their time bomb, it sat there. They started encrypting data, and they also started deleting snapshots. We also have capabilities around that. Joe Martin talked about worm-based capabilities, right? And so we have that capability with a technology called SnapLock, right? This fully compliant solution keeps any attack or any person, a disgruntled employee, if you will, right, from deleting snapshots. So not only are your snapshots immutable at this point, they're also fully protected from deletion of any kind, right? And you can set that date, and that date will not change, right? So these are fully compliant with the regulatory bodies out there as well. So DR versus backup, it's been spoken about a little bit. You know, the biggest concern you need to have here is that if you're replicating for DR, so, we think about DR from, burning building, deletion, corruption of some sort that might not be malicious, right? The problem is with malware and with ransomware, these are malicious and they will be replicated too, right? And, Joe Shields mentioned when we're replicating for a recovery point objective, right? And so, typically speaking, 4 hours is gonna be your minimum amount of replication time. In many cases, it's shorter than that. So if you've been attacked and it's been sitting out there for weeks or months on end, you've replicated that, right? So your DR is already infected, right? And impacted. So how do you recover from that? The answer is you really don't. You can't, right? I mean, so then we talk about what are the backup capabilities, and Joe Martin just went through those capabilities from a recovery standpoint from backup and how we protect those, right? So again, multi-tiered architecture, right? Do snapshots work? Yeah, most cases you're going to recover from a snapshot with no problem. unless it got deleted, right? The hackers were sophisticated enough to go in, be able to get my administrators' passwords and IDs, right, to then get into the system and delete those systems. So now where I'm at, well, okay, we have Snap Lock, right, that did not allow the deletion of those those snapshots. So I can recover from those in the case that my DR has been impacted and my backup may or may not have been impacted, right? So again, these are all different things that we have been talking about and you'll hear more about today. Yes.
Do the NetApps have the ability for MFA?
So not yet. We have our annual industry conference tomorrow. Right. It's the next 3 days, but the U.S. is tomorrow. And we have some announcements tomorrow. I can't say anything today. I will just say, go to insight.netapp.com and we have more to talk about. And it will be announced. So in our next release of operating systems, we will be implementing more technologies within our storage operating system to defend and mitigate malware and ransomware attacks.
Do you remember, though, right, from a membership perspective, administrative, the BSS doesn't have to be a member certificate. So you can protect against that in an entirely separate administrative network to isolate the air gap the control plane, because the BSS doesn't have to participate in the main. The SIS infrastructure does, but the administrative control doesn't. So there's a way to air gap administrative control in addition.
Yeah, no, I appreciate your commentary on that. I mean, there's, pre-announcements are something I'm allowed to do, right? So, but thank you for the question, because I was going to mention Insight, our industry conference tomorrow, and some of the announcements that will be made around that. But, to what Joe was saying and to your question, every vendor in this space is going to continue to work on your guys' behalf, right, to prevent and mitigate. Now, of course, the hackers are on the other side, working hard to get past our defenses, right? So we are in partnership together, right, to protect our data and to recover our data in the event that we do get attacked, right? And that's why you're here today to hear and understand more and learn more about all of the different strategies out there. And as everyone has said, and I've said and we'll repeat again, it's not a single, there's no single silver bullet, right? There are, it is a multi-layered architecture that you really have to be thinking about and considering if you haven't already deployed it, and continue to harden it and solidify it. So just a little bit, myth one, ransomware encrypts the backup contents, right? Snapshots can't be encrypted, they're read-only, right? Online backups can be deleted with SnapLock compliance and worm capabilities, right? As Joe Martin had mentioned, right? Worm keeps that from happening as well, right? And then finally, tape backup provides adequate protection from ransomware. It does, right? It is a way, but as Joe mentioned during his conversation, restoration from tape is a problem, right? I mean, in my mind, you have snapshot capabilities, you have online backup capabilities, and then you have tape, and that should be your last line of defense, right? Because if you have to recover from tape, you're talking about days, if not weeks, of downtime, right? Does it work? All three of us that have spoken today, right, will say, yeah, it does work. It is a line of defense, but it should be your last, in my opinion. I don't, Joe, if you agree with that or not, but.
Doing that could take you days or weeks even.
Well, yeah. It's not something you actually want to do. So.
Hey,
Steve. Yeah.
What's the major differences between Snap Vault and Snap
Vault? Well, so Snap Vault is a vaulted snapshot. Right. So we have Snap Mirror, which is a replication. Right. And whether you're doing that every 5, 15, you know, every hour. Right. It's a mirror. A vault is I took a snapshot. I vaulted it off. So it's much more like a backup. So as Joe was just talking about, like on a tape backup or even an online disk backup, you're doing an incremental. Right. And then you're, you know, maybe weekly you're doing a full. Well, every snapshot is a full, but it's just the block level changes that I am then replicating to another system. So it's no longer sitting on my primary system, right? In my primary volume that I took the snapshot, I vaulted that off to another system. Typically speaking, we vault that offsite, but I also have worked with customers that, hey, they will do a vault locally and then they will replicate that vault using a mirror, right? And that's, you know, another strategy, right, to get that offsite from an air gap perspective, because once I've replicated that off, I can seal it off. And it can't be, you know, touched at that point, assuming that we have the security in place that will keep, you know, hackers out of those, you know, that site that I'm vaulting it to. Does that answer your question?
It's kind of locked. I mean, so vault, it's really a snap out of the primary volume, right? Snap lock, there's two modes. And you didn't really talk about it. That's okay. Sorry.
Yeah, no, it's fine. Strategies even in a single system to have multiple virtual storage servers, and then it separates the plane of control, because a lot of times the way the attacks occur inside of NetApp systems aren't necessarily the administrator interfaces on NetApp. It's the authentication membership of the file system, be it Manifest or
Source.
So that's where really attackers attack that, because it looks like a member server inside of Windows, or it looks like an NFS file system that's sitting out of there. And so they leverage that to encrypt. Sorry.
Not necessarily the control vector, the control plane. And so the VSS separates those memberships, and so you can isolate that and then leverage Snap Vault and lock, even internal to one set of controllers or one cluster, and then you can replicate that same set. You know, one of the big things that, sorry, Steve, I'm stealing some of your thunder.
I appreciate it.
One of the important things to note, you know, we're a big proponent of NetApp. And in fact, a lot of the folks that we have had recover from ransomware attacks have had NetApp, and it's been really effective. But the thing that's not completely obvious is even in the volume, when you say your snapshot policy, those are read-only copies. And so they really can't be deleted unless you have administrative control of the control plane. Every single time we've seen, including that one college we talked about, the actual control plane wasn't influenced because it had separate credentials and access. It was really the fact that the file system, which acts as a member server, was corrupted and that data was encrypted. It's still a bad thing, but then the snapshots were actually maintained. So there's a whole subset of ways to recover data and protect data inside of NetApp, and nothing against any other storage vendor or anything else. It's something we completely believe in. In fact, our adaptive cloud platform is entirely built on it. So if you're an adaptive cloud customer, you know, you go delete a virtual machine, even if you delete the undelete feature inside of that, behind the scenes, we take snapshots of the entire environment every 15 minutes, and we've recovered deleted double delete mistakes for users multiple times. But it's just, they have the best recovery mechanisms and immutable capability. And by the way, this wasn't something they did, you know, this wasn't developed when the thing, I mean, this was Dave Hitz 101 back in the 90s. It's just a happy accident that a lot of these things occurred. So they've just got incredible capability for immutable copies and things like that. We've been using SnapLock for years, especially in healthcare associated with, diagnostic studies and things like that for patients. We have a great customer in Eastern Iowa that has been maintaining EEG studies for seizure children that have, there's legislation that you have to keep the study for life plus 7 years. And so they've been maintaining snap block volumes for the past 11 years and continue to do it. So, and it's a great strategy for, you know, maintaining data and protecting data forever. So probably went way deep in the weeds, so apologize.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's great, but that's why we're having this conversation, right? And you're welcome. And you know, I mean, I'll finish that point up, right? Because Joe brought up in SnapLock, there's enterprise and there's compliance, right? And I was talking about, you know, while most hacks that we've seen haven't been sophisticated enough or didn't get the, you know, they put a, you know, a file out there that is encrypting, right? It'll eventually, you know, time out, it'll go out and encrypt. That's not sophisticated enough to go out and start deleting my, you know, deleting my snapshots, right? So I can recover fairly quickly from that, find that, you know, that file before I recover from that snapshot, and I'm okay, right? Then you can get to enterprise, and I didn't bring it up. I really think more of compliance, right? Because if you want to put that ultimate lock on it, it would be compliance, right? Because again, if they're sophisticated enough to get the credentials to delete the snapshots, right, and mess with my snap vaults or my replications, right, they probably are sophisticated enough to delete a snap blocked enterprise version, right, because that just requires specific level credentials. It's not every sysadmin that can do that, right, but if they can get there, they can do that. And so the ultimate layer of protection is that compliance level of snap block. But I do appreciate, Joe, that you went a little deeper into that to explain it, because you just never know how deep you want to go in these conversations, right? I mean, and he's right. We have a lot of tools, right? And we could go deeper into these conversations or these concepts that I've kind of gone through fairly quickly. I did want to get us back on time. So no, that's all right. I think I'm still in the process of getting us a few minutes early. Amy, what did I have till 1:30? Okay, so we got 5 minutes left. We'll see if there's... you know, we talk about, so just a few more things. So Snap Center software, what is Snap Center? It manages our snapshots, right? And when it comes from an application snapshot standpoint, it makes them consistent, right? Consistent backups for the application to make sure that those snapshots are recoverable along with the application. So integrated data protection, so, you know, Joe was just up here, Joe Martin from Veeam, right? One of our, you know, great partners in the data protection space, as well as some others up here that we work with. Most all of these have, you know, really good deep integration with NetApp, not only in backing up our data, but in managing our snapshot capabilities, right? So, you know, your admins could use Veeam as an example to manage the snapshot capabilities of NetApp. Right, and do that from their interface so they don't have to learn multiple interfaces. So lots of integration with these different partners, both from the security slide that I had earlier as well as from the data protection slide there. These are, you know, as I mentioned earlier, reading and learning about things. So this is actually a six-part blog that a NetApp employee put out there. And so these are links to each one of them. And you will learn more about, you know, all, you know, I guess from the history to how, you know, how to protect and remediate from a, at least from a NetApp perspective, right? I think there's a lot more insight than just that. But it's really how we look at it and how we've embraced zero trust and multi-layered protection. Obviously for you guys and your data centers, we'll be a little bit on the, you know, protection against with, you know, Cloud Insights and Cloud Secure, right? And I didn't mention AIQ. I thought I had a slide on it. Maybe I went by it fairly quickly, but AIQ is our support site, right? If you're not familiar with that. And we are now integrating, you know, machine learning and artificial intelligence behind the data we collect from your systems to also help find, you know, ransomware or malware files within your infrastructure just by monitoring what's going on there. So, you know, we have back-end capabilities, we have front-end capabilities, and then we have the remediation capabilities. And that's how NetApp helps, you know, from a data security standpoint and fighting malware. Any last questions? Yeah.
General, are we going to get slides of
that's me. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate it.